earlier, today we're going to be talking about why you can't do in-person sales. We have heard
you
all
can't
the excuses.
Do it. No, yeah, I'm doing it.
Can't do it. And we've not only heard all the excuses, we've actually made all the excuses ourselves. So we totally understand. We're going to talk about the reasons why you can't and actually why you...
can.
Yeah, you can. But let's first talk about why you can't. All right.
Yes.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Welcome to our coffee talk. What's the number one reason that our prop photography students or people in our Snap Society community say they cannot do in-person sales?
I can't do in-person sales because I don't have a studio.
Yes.
I mean, let's talk about this. How many times has it crossed your mind that A, you're not a professional because you don't have a studio, B, you can't do in-person sales because you don't have a studio, your whole business is failing because you don't have a studio? No, it's not. Not true.
Anna, do you have a studio?
I do not have a studio.
Have you ever had a studio?
No, and do you know that I barely have an office? This is actually the corner of my basement.
I have never had a studio either, but in the beginning, I really thought that I was not legit without a studio.
It was a dream. I was like, I need a studio.
And now, I don't want to. If somebody gave me a studio space, I would say, no, thank you. I would say that. Would you say that?
I would say that. No, I would say that. A couple of years ago, I would not have. A couple of years ago, I was like, I need a studio to be a professional photographer.
Right.
Because people are like, where's your studio located?
My studio is located wherever you are located.
Yes, exactly.
In the natural light of Colorado. But here's the thing. It's like we can come up with so many great excuses as to why we can't do things. And not having a studio, it seems right. like a really legit excuse. Not only for shooting, but also for in-person sales. It seems impossible to do in-person sales without a studio. So, Anna, what do?
We do it at their house.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
We do.
Both of us do. All probably, 90% of our prop photography students do it at people's houses.
Yeah.
It's the way to do it. It's great. You'll
it's
love it.
It's convenient for everybody. It's convenient for everybody
yes,
to just
it
do
is.
It at their house. I don't have to clean my house. They don't have to get a babysitter.
Yeah. It's sold. Just,
yeah, sold. And we're premium price photographers. So it's not like, you know, you can't be a premium price photographer and do in-person sales in the home. You absolutely can. So if that is your excuse for not doing in-person sales, we have just relieved you. We've relieved you of that excuse. I'm not sure if you wanted that relief, but we just gave it to you. Okay,
yes.
Number two. I can't do in-person sales because A, I'm not a salesperson. That's me. That was my excuse. Or I'm not an extrovert. Well, guess what?
That's me.
I'm an extrovert. She's not.
I'm not.
Or I'm socially awkward.
That's me too.
See, I don't see you as socially awkward.
That's because you didn't know me 5 years ago.
Okay, so have you heard this excuse before?
I have heard that excuse and I have made that excuse.
Yes, I have made the excuse too about the salesperson. Like, I am not selling to my clients. I love my clients too much to be selling to them. And what was yours?
Mine was that I'm an introvert. I don't like talking to people. And I sure as heck was not going to like selling to people. And I just thought for sure it would just end, you know, like in a very large disaster is what I thought would happen.
It would end in a large disaster.
But in-person sales.
Well, but, yeah. And you know what's funny to me is when our prop photography students are like, I'm just not an extrovert like Jamie, so I can't do it. And I'm like,
right.
I'm an extrovert and I didn't do it for 3 years because I was so scared. So it doesn't matter if you're an extrovert. That doesn't mean it'll be easy for you. I promise. It's still going to be hard, you know, getting over the fear of actually doing it for sure.
Right.
No matter what personality type, maybe 1% of people actually want to do it, but I know I didn't and I'm pretty extroverted.
I didn't. And I still sometimes don't want to.
So what did you do to get over that?
It's like ripping off a band-aid, you know, and I went into it prepared. I think one of the biggest things is knowing what you are doing. Mm-hmm. And, so going into it prepared, knowing what you're going to say, how you're going to, what the flow of the actual in-person sales appointment's going to be like. I personally, this is a little tiny secret for the introvert, socially awkward person of me. I have topics of conversation already. This is going like a little too far. If you are good at making conversation, you don't need to do this, but I am not. And so I actually have like the same conversation with my client, with all of my clients. Mm. And I know what questions to ask.
I think that's great. That's a great way for you to prepare. Yep. And to kind of think about, okay, what could come up and figure out ways to talk with them.
Yes, exactly.
So one of the things that I do is I just get really excited. Like, I just turn on the excitement and I'm like, oh, I'm so excited.
You look excited.
Yeah. No. Shocking, no. I know. But you know, that just being coming in as excited and can't wait to show them their gorgeous pictures instead of coming in as a salesperson, that right. makes a really big difference,
yeah.
I think.
I think the mindset shift of it being an experience for them,
uh-huh.
you need to have that mindset shift so that they can have that mindset shift. And then it's not really awkward at all.
Well, and here's the thing too. For me, what I realized after doing my first and second one, it really finishes off the whole process.
Yes.
Because before I would put up a gallery and I was like, oh, this is so convenient for everybody. I have a gallery up. But then I didn't know if they even liked the pictures. I mean, I knew because right. they were kind of ordering stuff or sometimes not ordering anything. And so I assumed they didn't like it. But what it came down to is that number one, they didn't have a reason to order because I wasn't right there and I wasn't helping them. But number two, I just never really got to know my clients fully because I didn't know what they were oohing and aahing over. And so I didn't get that gratification as a photographer, which is really sad because you put all, you know, all this yes. work into shooting and editing. And then it's like this grand finale isn't there. And
right.
the reveal doing the in-person sale, that is a grand finale for not only your client, but also you as a photographer. So,
yes, you're going to love it.
You're going to love it. Third you're reason you cannot do in-person sales no matter what. What's the third biggest reason that we hear?
Time. Mm. So it's inconvenient. You don't have time. They don't have time. It's inconvenient for everyone.
Yes. That was great.
We hear that all the time. A, I do not have time for in-person. Let's tackle that one first. I don't have time for in-person sales. I'm already shooting 10 sessions a week. There's no way I could do in-person sales for all of those. Mm-hmm. I can't be away from my family any more than that. I can't. It's just not going to happen. Mm-hmm. Jamie, how do we solve that problem?
We solve that problem by saying, do you really want to make money? No. Here's the deal. When you are making a certain amount of money, then you do not have to shoot as much. If I'm able to make the same amount of money off of one photo shoot that I could have made off of five photo shoots, then guess what? I'm saving a whole lot of time. I'm saving time from editing and I'm saving time from shooting. When you do in-person sales, yes. The truth is you will add time. You will add a whole another hour and a half, 2 hours if you count drive time and maybe you stay there later to the in-person sale, right? But, and it's probably not even gonna take you that long, but let's just say 2 hours. But you're gonna have to do so much less shooting that time makes up for itself
right.
because of the money that you're gonna be able to make yes. off of that one in-person sale.
For example, my max session, shoot and burn, the highest I ever got at shoot and burn was $300.
Mm-hmm.
Now, my average sale as an in-person sales photographer is about $2,500. And so, instead of shooting, I can't do the math, okay? Instead of shooting like 10 sessions to make $3,000, I can shoot one session and make almost $3,000. Mm-hmm. So the time that is spent is so much smaller overall. The time per session is more, but the time overall to make the same amount of money is much, much less.
Right. And my biggest thing was I was really worried that I was going to be inconveniencing my client. Like,
right.
they're not going to want to add a whole nother time. Okay, people, your client has only come out one time. That was to shoot with you. Now, maybe you had a consulting meeting. I do all of that on the phone, so I don't make them come anywhere. But it's like they're coming for the shoot, which that's what they expect to do. They have to show up for the shoot, right? Well, then you're going to ask them to do one more thing, and that is to have a reveal. And the whole point of that is that it's an opportunity for them to be a part of this reveal. It's not something that is an inconvenience for them because they're excited about it, because it's still part of the experience, because you communicated with them about it from the very beginning. It's not something that you're just springing on them. They know in communication, whether it's email, whatever, conversation, that they're gonna get to do, get, not half, to do the in-person sale with you. And so that was the biggest thing for me, is that I just thought nobody's going to want to take an extra night, an extra hour of their time to do this in-person sale. And what have you experienced, Anna?
Let me actually just tell you, which sounds more inconvenient? Having a night where I come to your house, I show you all of your images, we go through and choose things for your house, and then a week or two later, everything that you picked out shows up on your doorstep, hand delivered by me, mm-hmm. and you have everything all done. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's one way. The other way is you get an online gallery, you look at it by yourself, then you have to look at it with your husband, then you gotta show the kids, then your 2 weeks span of time is up and you haven't ordered anything, and then you have to call me to ask me to get your gallery back up, and then you have to call me to ask me questions about what size you should get, or what this actual product is, or how you can package it, all these different things. And we go back and forth and back and forth and back and forth, which sounds like a better, more enjoyable, more convenient experience for your client. It's right. You showing up, mm-hmm. doing the work for them. That's what you're doing. You're providing that service for them.
Yeah, and it's all about mindset. And so if you have the mindset that it's inconvenience for them, it will be an inconvenience for them, because that's how you're going to portray it to them. If you portray it as something that is a privilege, people thank me. When I am writing testimonies, that's what they talk about. They're like, I can't believe that you would do all this. This is the icing on the cake for people. And so really, your mindset has to shift to, I am giving my client a full experience. If right. I don't do this in-person sale, then I'm cutting them short of something that could be a full-on experience. So the whole thing with the inconvenience, it's all in our head. It was in my head, it was in Anna's head, and it's in your head. So get it out of your head.
So the three reasons you can't do in-person sales, they're not reasons that you can't do in-person
sales.
They're
excuses.
Surprise!
And that's a painful truth, right?
That
they're really just excuses. It's like, we're giving you all these tools and these answers, but are you gonna take it and just make more excuses out of it? Or are you gonna take it and say, you know what? I'm doing it. I'm doing it.
Exactly. Okay, so we wanna hear from you guys below. Let us know, what of those excuses are standing out to you?
Do you have another excuse that maybe
What are your other excuses, your other reasons for not doing in-person sales?
All right, we're excited to hear from you. Have a great week, and we'll see you next week for our coffee talk. Same time, same place.
Same
Some
time.
Inspiration for your coffee break.